Lovely people, my name is Sonia Bakus. I'm based in Stony Stratford, fine art artist, art teacher and art presenter. Today I would like to do a workshop with you how to design Greek vase. We can see here on this picture, I will bring closer to you, is quite a lot of different shapes of vase, and most common one is amphora. This is a really good topic to develop skills how to do symmetrical drawing, and as well how to do decorations, and also very good to get know a bit of Greek mythology. Greeks were excellent, exceptional artists, designers, architects. They were very good sculptures, for example Phidias, and it's not enough time to explain everything. So today I will just explain two things about these vases. It was really very popular two styles, black figure vases and red figures. And you need for this workshop, I'm using big A3 paper, but if you don't have A3, you can use A4. It's not a problem. Preferably for background, white paper. And we will cut today something from paper. So we need scissors. We need glue. We need color paper. I chosen black paper. Quite a big piece of paper, but you can use red, yellow, ochre. It will be better if it's dark, because this is another part, interesting part, and I really would like use dark background for pastel, oil pastels. I would like to work today with oil pastel. My preferred oil pastel are Pentel, and they're quite affordable and quite well covering pastels. So what I do first, I get this black paper, fold in half. You don't have to do it. You can draw shape as you go, but it's easier and quicker. So what I do is actually I draw the shape of amphora. Like this, I don't know, you can see still, right? And then handle. Yep. And I will cut this along and open, and I have this ready-made, already prepared before by me. I also like color pencils. They're really quite good because it's oil color pencils. They cover again quite well, so I can start doing patterns. But now explaining about patterns. That's examples of quite popular patterns. Some of them, the sign of the sun, waves, as you can see here, and leaves, another waves, more swirls. Why I like Greek art? It's fascinating for me because it's quite often based on history and mythology. So we have lots of interesting stories about heroes, about goddesses, about gods, with main god Zeus. And talking about Zeus and Greek mythology, I think I'm gonna attempt to do Pegasus. Pegasus was a creature, actually horse with wings, as you can see. It was a son of Zeus, believe or not. I will explain more about Pegasus while I'm doing. Here is another vase, quite a good example. Please have a look closely if it's focused enough, sharp enough. We can see quite a lot of geometrical shapes, but some stylized horses as well, some swans, I reckon, here. So you can use your imagination and make your own patterns. However, it will be good if you can pick up one of Greek myths and use as a centerpiece here. It is Pegasus was born from headless Medusa. Medusa was a sea monster, which before was a beautiful maiden, and she commit her life to Athena goddess. But Zeus, Athena's father, fell in love with beautiful maiden and possessed her, and she became pregnant. And Athena got very furious and angry at this maiden, not at her father, and turned her into Medusa. Medusa was a furious monster which turned everybody into stone once you look in her eyes. She was careless and worse, turning worse and worse, and then one hero, Perseus, he saved people from this monster, chopping her head off. Once he chopped her head off, from her body jump out Pegasus. So that was the birth of Pegasus. So that's why I would like to draw Pegasus as a centerpiece. So we have a black background, white pencil, color pencil, and I'm drawing. This is actually quite good exercise to get used to horse body. It is quite a lot of printed books how to draw horse, so we can have a big bean shape. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, I will try to. We have another oval shape for its head. We can add ears and obviously legs. And horse back legs are quite massive, quite strong, right? And then tail, right? And wings. I'm not gonna confuse you and add more second wing. It's good enough to show one wing, an eye of course. So if you can see, I can bring little bit closer. So this is a Pegasus centerpiece, and I will use now oil pastels to make patterns as well. I can use white, I can use brown, ochre. I will keep up with kind of natural colors. So let's see how these patterns work. Yeah, can you see something? Maybe a little bit with white is easier. White on black look very good and elegant. While I got this white, I'm gonna correct now outlines on Pegasus. You can see how good these pastels are. Really cover very well. Some pastels, all oil pastels, are not really opaque enough, not really helping, especially if you do drawing on a color paper, right? Now I'm going to add some of this interesting decoration in the middle. This is, again, I repeat myself, a really good exercise to learn some symmetry. So I just try to repeat same shapes here on both sides, one more here, one more there, and then we have similar situation on both sides. So kind of keep repeating. What else? I may use now ochre leaves, make little less visible, right? And then some line here, nice brown. And I feel this brown shape with color just to outline with white pastel. And even if you go over with white color on the top of the brown, that's fine. It's less white then, but it's nicely merged with each other, blend with each other. So it's interesting to look at. Again, some outlines. And voila, that's it. That's the topic of Greek vase. Remember, Greek art is very vast, very, very interesting, and worthy to check more how Greeks design and being architects build amazing temples and places, worship places. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed.